छोड़ इतना दूंगी।
मुझे पीना है ना अभी यार, सच्ची ने इतना बहस मत करो ना, तो तुम्हें बहस करने की मौका।
Good afternoon to everyone present here with us today. This is Sriyan from IJCP. I would like to welcome all the viewers who have joined our platform for better exchange of knowledge that is going to be shared by your keynote speaker, Doctor, for today's session. With much pleasure and honor, I would like to welcome a very renowned doctor, Dr. Ritu Santwani. Ma'am is MBBS MD, Obs and Gynecology, founder and CEO of Shyam Well Woman Clinic at 360 Degree Healthcare Studio in Pune. With the help of ma'am and her wonderful insight, we will be taking a close look on today's topic, which is FAQ of HPV vaccination. Now, without any further delay, I would like to welcome ma'am at our forum and would like to hand over the session to her. Over to you, ma'am.
Thank you. So friends, as we all are aware, these days lot of discussion. Thank you. These days lot of discussion is going on over the HPV vaccination. There is lot of confusion everyone is having in their mind related to HPV. How many shots we have to give? Whether we can give this vaccine in pregnancy or no? Whether this vaccine, if we started the 3 doses and if the patient hasn't turned up in between, so is it like that we have to start the full course schedule again? So related to this frequently asked questions, I have made the today's PPT. So hello everyone, I'll just share the screen. My all presentations always start with Mata Durga Stuti. Ya Devi Sarvabhuteshu Chikitsa Rupeṇa Sansita Namastasyai 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 Namo. So friends, this what are the frequently asked questions related to this HPV vaccination and need of the hour? So we all know related to this effective HPV counseling, the need and strategies. What are the frequently asked questions related to this? What are the myths related to this HPV vaccination? And how to address the common concerns about the HPV vaccine? So just stop this. So friends, as we all are aware, the persistent infection with HPV can cause genital warts and cancers of the cervix, vagina, anus and vulva. India has a huge burden of HPV-related diseases. So, as we all know, the statistics of the 2020, it is shown first cervical cancer, vaginal cancer, anal cancer, and vulval cancer. Though in India, post-breast cancer, cervical cancer is the major cause related to the death of the woman in our country. Early prevention of certain HPV-related diseases and cancers can be achieved with HPV vaccination. Low SS2 and uptake of HPV vaccination. Only 1% of the girls reported of receiving the HPV vaccine in Asia. So, lack of awareness regarding HPV, a major hurdle to the acceptance of the HPV vaccine. It is critical to conduct effective education programs to raise awareness and acceptance of HPV vaccination, and in turn to boost public confidence regarding safety of vaccination. So friends, we can see tips to achieve high HPV vaccination rates. So here we can go one by one that it's very important to create the awareness and important to recommend this vaccine strongly. Bundling vaccine recommendation, offering the decision support tools, strengthen the doctor-patient relationship. So now coming to the today's discussion, what are the frequently asked questions? So First important question, what the usually, once we counsel the patient and what usually the patient asks to us, how can the HPV infection can be prevented? Because these days we are seeing a lot of patients suffering from the HPV. So, as per CDC guidelines, the routine screening for women in the age group of 21 to 65 years can help prevent the cervical cancer. HPV vaccination is very well tolerated and demonstrated to help protect against certain HPV-related infections, diseases, including cancers caused by the HPV vaccine type, and when given in the recommended age group, and the safe sexual practices, being in a mutually monogamous relationship and using the condoms during sexual intercourse can help to provide some protection against HPV infection. Which HPV vaccines are available in India? Bivalent, quadrivalent, and nanovalent. So these days, only the quadrivalent and nanovalent we are using. Then again, the next question comes: do all the HPV vaccine offers the same coverage against the HPV infection? So friends, what the studies have shown and what the clinical trials have shown, the bivalent HPV vaccine is giving you the protection from HPV 16 and 18, which is responsible for more than 70% of the cervical cancers. Then quadrivalent HPV vaccine will give you protection from 6, 11, 16, 18, 70% of cervical cancers, additionally 90% of the genital warts. Then nanovalent vaccine, which will give you the protection from 6, 11, 16, 18, additionally it is covering 31, 33, 45, 52, and 58. So again, the question comes, who should get vaccinated against HPV? Only the females or the male should be also recommended for this vaccine? HPV vaccination dosage schedule recommendations by FOCI and IAP. In India, catch-up vaccination may be offered to older women. All the females starting from the 9 years of age should be vaccinated. Quadrivalent HPV vaccine is licensed for the use of 9 years till 45 years in females, and nanovalent from 9 to 26 in females and 9 to 15 in the males. So friends, still what the studies we are having for this nanovalent vaccine is 9 to 26 years in female. So now let's have a quick interaction. Very important whether this HPV vaccine can be administered during pregnancy, yes or no. So, friends, this HPV vaccines are not recommended for the use in the pregnant woman. Limited data on the safety of HPV vaccination in pregnancy. As per clinical studies conducted, no specific safety concerns were identified for the outcome of pregnancy, spontaneous abortion, miscarriage, stillbirth, or fetal development. In the absence of a well-controlled studies in pregnant women, HPV vaccination is not recommended in pregnancy. What should be done if a woman finds out if she is pregnant and has received a HPV vaccine? If the pregnancy occurs following the first dose of HPV vaccination, the subsequent dose should be delayed until the pregnancy is completed. Termination of pregnancy is not indicated if the vaccination was carried out inadvertently during the pregnancy. The remaining dose of the vaccine should be withheld and can be given 6 weeks post-delivery. Then again, the question comes, is the HPV vaccine safe for the people who are immunocompromised and or are infected with HIV? Whether it is yes, no, or not sure. So what the studies have shown us, that this safety, immunogenicity, and the efficacy of quadrivalent HPV vaccine has not been evaluated in the immunocompromised individuals. The immunologic response to the HPV vaccine may be diminished in immunocompromised individuals. Then, again, a very important query comes: can an HPV a woman with who is breastfeeding can receive the HPV vaccination? So, yes, no, or not sure. So, friends, all the studies have shown that breastfeeding is not a contraindication for HPV vaccination. There are a lot of clinical trials have done that all have shown that HPV vaccines generally do not affect the safety of breastfeeding mothers or their infants. Then the question comes, do sexually active people benefit from the HPV vaccination? Yes, no, or not sure? Friends, then the studies have shown that HPV vaccination may benefit, sorry for that. HPV vaccine can help to prevent the acquisition of new HPV infections for the strains that the vaccine covers that they have not been exposed to. So, catch up vaccination programs of sexually active females who are not previously vaccinated may help in obtaining the rapid reductions in the incidence of all HPV related cancers and diseases. Then, the studies have shown. Should an individual who is infected with HPV still get the HPV vaccine? People who have an HPV infection and an or abnormal pap test should still get the HPV vaccine if they are in the appropriate age group. Studies have shown the vaccine may help to protect the individuals infected with HPV against the high-risk type of HPV types that they have not acquired. The vaccination does not cure the current HPV infections. So again, the guidelines have shown that from 9 to 14 years, the 0 and 6 months, and 15 to 45 years for the quadrivalent vaccine, 0 to 6 schedule has been recommended. Then for this nanovalent, for the females, 9 to 26 years, 0 to 6. And for the males, 9 to 15 years, 0 to 6 also has been recommended. Then, question comes, why this vaccine is recommended in such a young age? So, friends, vaccination is a key to help to prevent against the HPV-related diseases. HPV vaccination prior to 15 years of age results in 2 times higher the HPV antibody titers when compared with vaccinating at 15 years of age or older. Early vaccination helps to provide the higher reduction in the lifetime risk of cervical cancer. Now, who are the people who did receive the HPV vaccine? Of course, we have just discussed the people who have had a life-threatening allergic reaction to any ingredient of an HPV vaccine or to a previous dose of HPV vaccine. Pregnant females and the people with a moderate or severe illness should wait until they are better. So, what should be done in the case if there is a missed dose? So, what are the guidelines? The HPV vaccine should not be restarted if there is an interruption of the vaccine schedule or a delay in between the doses. Only the remaining doses should be administered when the recipient is willing to complete the schedule. Can the HPV vaccine be used interchangeably with one another? No. A big no for that. There is limited evidence regarding the safety and efficacy of the HPV vaccines when used interchangeably with one another. The available vaccines may contain the different components. Every effort should be made to use the same vaccine for every dose. So now the question comes that can this vaccine can be concomitantly given with the other vaccines like meningococcal, tetanus toxoid or DPT? So yes, we can give that vaccine. The studies have shown concomitant vaccination of the HPV with other vaccine has not been demonstrated to compromise the tolerability and immunogenicity of the individual vaccines. So usually this vaccine is well tolerated. Some common side effects has been noticed like redness, pain, swelling, and systemic adverse side effects such as headache and fever. So now what are the myths related to this HPV vaccine? So myth number one, natural HPV infection already creates a protective antibody response. So there is no need for the vaccination. So what the studies have clarified that it does not enter the body's circulation and does not cause the local inflammation. Antibody response is low to absent. Then HPV vaccine can protect only against the cervical cancer? No. So they can protect related to this genital warts also, and the different cancers, cancer vulva, anus, vagina also. So Is it like that once we have given the HPV vaccination, still it's mandatory to go for the pap smear testing as advised by the guidelines? Of course, yes, it is recommended by the guidelines that at it is advised the pap smear checking should be done. Then HPV vaccine only protect girls, boys do not need them. So all the studies have shown, friends, that this HPV transmission, this is a very recent studies have come in March 2023 only, that HPV transmission from females to male is higher than from males to females. So this is very important. And in the males, the chances of the recurrent warts is also very high. Males remain susceptible to HPV infections throughout their life. Only a minute, I need her. Yes. HPV vaccine contain the harmful ingredients. HPV vaccine contains the ingredients. Just a second, just a second, please. Can you mute me for a minute? Actually, I'm in the opening. Mute me for the minute.
Ma'am, there is a mute option at your
I'm
screen,
not
so.
able to get now. That's why I'm telling you. Just a second. Let me check here.
Sure.
Not
Let me
getting
just,
the
not an issue. I will mute you.
So sorry for that, because this is the OPD time, no? Some of the so
Not an
HPV
issue, ma'am.
vaccine, So HPV vaccine contain the harmful ingredients. There are a lot of studies have come that no, this is also a myth. HPV vaccine contains the ingredients that have been generally well tolerated. For example, they contain the aluminium like hepatitis B, Tdap vaccine. Aluminium helps to boost the body's immune response to the vaccine, so nothing like that. Then I'm being an infertility specialist. A lot of patients are coming for this and telling that HPV vaccine can cause the fertility related issues. So no, it does not cause the any reproductive problems in the woman. Then again the question comes, there is a lot of queries what we have discussed, that as just I have mentioned, is the pap test is recommended? Yes. Can HPV infection be avoided by simply by using the condom? No, because we all know this HPV infection transmitted by the body fluids. So even by the kissing and the anal sex also it can be spread. Then just now I clarified that why does my son needs the HPV vaccine? Because it is transmission of the HPV from females to male is more. And the chances of the recurrent vaginal warts is recurrent genital warts is also higher in the males. So, yeah. Then studies have come that recommending the HPV vaccine as a way to help prevent against the certain HPV related cancers. Physicians generally link the discussion of sexual health issues while recommending the vaccine. HPV vaccination is for cancer prevention. Preventing cancer is better than treating it. So studies have shown, friends, the diseases prevent by the HPV vaccine. So and it is recommended for both boys and girls. Then effective response to address the common questions and concerns. These are usually the common questions what we are getting. That usually we are giving the HPV vaccine and it just seems to be very well tolerated. And it's much better to give the girls this vaccine before they are sexually active. When usually the ladies are coming in my OPD, I always advise them, hey, please take the vaccination not only for you, but also for your daughter also. So this is more or the less the same thing. So Now coming to a very important question, but can HPV infection be avoided by simply by using a condom? Using a condom during sexual intercourse offers only partial protection against HPV transmission, as the virus can exit on the skin sites which are not covered by the condom and can be transmitted by genital skin to skin contact. HPV vaccine may offer nearly 100% protection against the persistent infection by the HPV types targeted by them. Yes, of course, the pap smears is still needed after the vaccination. Yes. So, usually we recommend all the patients who are coming in our OP. And I'll stop sharing. So, thank you, friends, for your attention and your time. Meanwhile, if there are any questions, I am ready to answer the questions.
Yes, ma'am, there are a few questions. So,
yes, yes, dear.
So, ma'am, the first question from our audience is, how do you navigate conversation with patients who may be hesitant about vaccinating their child against HPV?
See, these days the scenario is different. I where practice, I am practicing in Goregaon Park in Pune. I am getting all the corporate clients. So my patients are very, very well educated. So only I have to tell them in detail. Itne jyada educated hai ki wo sab Google se sab kuch karke aate hai. So only I have to explain them clearly that what are the risk factors if they are not giving this vaccine. So once you counsel them properly, of course the patient is ready. Only the main thing is that the cost is a big hindrance. So if our government will make it in this the national immunization program, I think more and more girls will be benefited.
Thank you, ma'am. The next question is, how do you approach HPV vaccination in immunocompromised or high-risk population?
No, for immunocompromised, as I showed you the slides also, for the immunocompromised patient, the results are not as such as guaranteed. So whenever we are giving the patient, if the patient is already suffering from HIV or other diseases, you have to take the signature of the patient. Yes, already the immunity is less, but if they can take, of course, the prevention is better than cure, but you can't give the total guarantee. But in this act of the CPA, better to take the signature.
Okay, ma'am. The next question is, what strategies have you found successful in addressing vaccine hesitancy related to HPV vaccines?
Okay. Strategies, I can think we have to aware the more and more patients, more and more publics we have to aware. So you can approach them via any normal meetings or by the ad in the newspaper or by the, I think, leave all this apart, the social media has having the word power, wo kisi ke paas bhi nahi hai. So you can, usually the patients these days are coming that they have seen one or the one reel on the Insta or in the Facebook. From that they got the information. So I think more and more awareness is needed. We have to make it like a viral videos on this, viral reels on this, which are constantly, whenever they open their social media, constantly they are able to see that reel. So that will, I think, will give a bombardment on their mind that they have to take this vaccine.
Thank you, ma'am. There's one last question.
Yeah.
What are the recommended dosing schedule for HPV vaccines and how do they differ?
Okay. I already have shown the slides on this. So usually, see, usually what is recommended is the 0 to 6. So till now, what the guidelines have shown that 0 to 6 for this both, and especially if the girl is coming less than of 15 years, the two doses are recommended, 0 and 6. So whether you are going for this nanovalent or whether you are going for the quadrivalent, only see the for this vaccine, what the studies have shown, if you have gone to the criteria by the WHO criteria for the studies have shown that from 9 to 45 years of age, only with Gardasil 9, which is the costliest injection, is available, but that is giving you the protection from the 9 strains of the viruses. But for that virus, the studies have shown up to the 9 to 26 years of age. And similarly, for the males, they are recommending from 9 to 15 years of age till what the studies are available. Now, there are different papers are coming that only one shot of the cervical cancer vaccine will be effective. Still, a lot of studies are needed because such kind of paper is still not published by the Cochrane or PubMed. There are a lot of different studies are going on. Still, the protocol what we are following is 0 to 6. And if the girl is less than 15 years, then 0 and 6.
Thank you so much, ma'am, for answering all our questions. That's all from our audience. And ma'am,
Yeah.
before concluding today's session, ma'am, any last remark from you?
My last remark is for that key. Prevention is always better than cure. So I always tell the patient, see, this cervical cancer is the type of the cancer for their prevention. The vaccine is available. Usually in India, the first cancer is the breast cancer. For the breast cancer, nothing is like that. So once we diagnose the breast cancer, we have to remove the breast. But for this prevention of cervical cancer, yes, of course, the vaccine is available. So please take the advantage if the vaccine is available. So prevention is better than cure.
Thank you so much, ma'am. That's all from our end as well. And thank
Yeah.
you for joining us today. With your permission, ma'am, I would like to conclude today's session.
Yes, yes, yes.